It's the show everyone is talking about.
Bridgerton!
Bridgerton.
Bridgerton. Bridgerton.
Bridgerton.
But what questions are people asking about the hit period drama from Shondaland and Netflix? Here are the answers to some of the most searched for questions. A warning, if you haven't seen all of Bridgerton season 1 yet, there are plenty of spoilers ahead. Bridgerton is based on a best-selling series of romance novels by Julia Quinn. Series 1 is based on the first book named The Duke and I. Each book focuses on a different Bridgerton sibling and how they find true love. Is it based on a true story? No. The story is fictional and most of the characters in Bridgerton were created in the mind of Julia Quinn and brought to life on screen by showrunner Chris Van Dusen. That said, the world of the Ton definitely existed at one point in British history. Rich families did indeed move to London specifically for the social season. And young women from those families were presented before the real-life Queen Charlotte. That was a tradition which continued until 1958.
Flawless, my dear.
The series is set in 1813, during what is known as the Regency era. Generally, it refers to the period of time when King George III was deemed unfit to rule due to mental illness. His eldest son, then the Prince of Wales, ruled as Prince Regent until his father's death in 1820. King George III is briefly shown in season 1, while his wife Queen Charlotte is an imposing figure throughout.
Lady Whistledown.
Lady Whistledown.
The author.
Do we know a Lady Whistledown?
Surely Lady Whistledown cannot be her true name.
Now, Lady Whistledown herself is fictional, but bears some resemblance to gossip writers in 18th and 19th century England. These were usually columns within newspapers or magazines, and would refer to the subjects of their gossip by code names. It was usually easy to figure out who they were referring to.
This one is different. This one lists subjects by name.
In the show, Daphne is 18. Historically, debutantes would come out when the parents decided it was time, as we see Lady Bridgerton discuss with Eloise.
Things you should be learning yourself to prepare for your debut.
Making a simpering conversation and pretending not to wince every time a man treads on my toes during a waltz.
Generally, this was between the ages of 15 to 18. None of this debutante pressure applied to the men, however. The Duke of Hastings, who talks about having gone to university and been on travels around the world, is 28. British hereditary titles like Viscount and Duke sound fancy, but what do they actually mean? These titles were assigned to high-ranking families, usually related to the royal family in some way. Titles like Prince or Princess are reserved for people who are actually born into the family. The rest of the ranks are titles which can be given or inherited. Top of the list is Duke, and fourth in the ranking is a Viscount. Dukes generally ruled over what's called a duchy, so in Simon's case, that would be Hastings. Viscounts back in those days held an administrative and judicial role, which is why Anthony is always so busy in his study when not gallivanting with his opera singer. If you listen carefully, you can hear the melodies of Lady Ariana Grande or one Billie of Eilish playing in the backgrounds of some scenes. There are 6 classical covers of modern music in the series, including Shawn Mendes and Taylor Swift. 4 of them are played by the Vitamin String Quartet, who have been making covers like these since 1999. It wouldn't be Bridgerton without this great cast, like the incomparable Julie Andrews as the voice of Lady Whistledown.
Dearest reader, the time has come to place our bets for the upcoming social season.
Phoebe Dynevor, who made her TV debut on British school drama Waterloo Road, plays Daphne Bridgerton.
And you should know something about me, Your Grace. I will not have this go wrong.
Reggae Jean Page is the handsome Duke of Hastings. You may recognise him from previous Shondaland series, For the People.
Perhaps there is an answer to our collective Lady Whistledown issue.
And from Derry, as in Derry Girls, to the Ton, we have Nicola Coughlan as Penelope Featherington.
But do you not think the boy bears a passing resemblance to Lady Trowbridge's footman?
Penelope? What a barb.
Then there's Jonathan Bailey as Anthony Bridgerton, Luke Thompson as Benedict Bridgerton, Luke Newton as Colin Bridgerton, Claudia Jesse as Eloise Bridgerton, Ruth Gemmell as Lady Bridgerton, Adjoa Ando as Lady Danbury, Polly Walker as Lady Featherington, Ruby Barker as Marina Thompson, Harriet Keynes as Philippa Featherington, Bessie Carter as Prudence Featherington, and Golda Rocheville as Queen Charlotte. Now, was the prince in Harry Potter? Eagle-eyed Potter fans may well recognise the handsome Prince of Prussia, Prince Friedrich, who was played by Freddie Stromer. He also played the much less charming Cormac McLaggen in the Harry Potter film series. If you've read the books, then you'll know exactly what the meaning of the bees which make their appearance at the start and end of Series 1 signify. In the source material, Daphne's father dies suddenly due to a bee sting, making Antony both deathly afraid of bees and the sudden Viscount of Bridgerton. Will we see the bee again? Who knows? Now this is a question you'll know the answer to if you watched to the end of Season 1, so this is your last warning if you don't want to know. And if you're still here, then you'll know it's revealed Lady Whistledown is none other than Penelope Featherington. We can't wait to see what happens next with everyone's favourite Regency gossip writer. And the number one question is, will there be a season two? That's a secret only Lady Whistledown knows. One couldn't possibly comment. Until then, you can catch all of Series 1, now streaming on Netflix.